Yeah.
Gaza is under strain again. Palestinian workers struggle to rebuild their smuggling tunnel to reach beneath the border and into Egypt. Each of these tents hides an underground passage. For 6 years, they were used to avoid Israel's import restrictions, tightened after its sworn enemy, the Islamist group Hamas, came to power here. But now they're idle. Smugglers like Abu Ahmed, who brought in goods and cheap Egyptian fuel, have seen their booming businesses literally collapse. 95% of the tunnels were shut, totally destroyed, he says. It's Egypt's military across the border that's taken action as it fights Islamic extremists in the Sinai region. As armed militants attack strategic Egyptian targets, Hamas is accused of supporting them because of its close ties to Egypt's ousted president and his Muslim Brotherhood movement. Hamas denies it's involved. Now all Palestinians trying to exit Gaza through its main Rafah crossing point find it much more difficult. Egypt's authorities limit numbers, saying they're worried about security. Yusuf is one of many travelers who's stuck. He's trying to reach the UK, where he's got a scholarship at Oxford University.
We live in Gaza. We are not responsible for the mistakes of Hamas or any other party. So why are we being punished collectively? This is the question.
Life in this crowded coastal strip has got tougher as the government's found itself on the wrong side of events in the Middle East.
Not long ago, Palestinians here and their Hamas leaders hoped to benefit from the new regional order emerging from the Arab uprisings. It looked like they'd bring in more sympathetic Islamist governments. But now that's changed, and Gaza actually feels more isolated than it did before.
But Hamas politicians insist they'll get through this crisis.
We started with the political isolation, with the kind of boycotts, collective punishment, incursion, wars against Gaza. But we succeeded to pass this. And I think we have the ability and the capacity to pass these challenges.
On the streets, Hamas is feeling the pressure. And recently, its military wings turned out in response. Shows of force that say, for now, Gaza remains firmly in their hands. Yolande Nel, BBC News, Gaza City.